Don't take that foolishness in 2013. We got much work to do. Lord, help us.
Hallelujah.
He said, I am the Lord. I mean, still in verse 5. A lot of that, I don't know how I got all that out of verse 5. But he said, I am the Lord. And there is no one else. Oh, see, listen. Do you notice how many times God is saying the same thing?
Yeah.
And these verses, that means, duh, we need to get that.
Yes.
I'm the Lord. I'm doing it. But you know what it is? Because, oh Lord, help us. We want to be in charge so bad. Oh, Lord, deliver us from wanting to be in charge. We want to run our life and everybody else's life. Oh, we want to run our business and everybody else's business. We think our opinion. Oh, God, help me today. Can I come back next week? Y'all let me back in the building next week? Okay, if you don't, I got kids, don't worry about it. But we think our opinion sometimes is higher than God's opinion. And if we think it's higher than God's, then surely no mere mortal has a better opinion than what we have. Oh, God needs to stick a pin and bet some of that air out of our opinion. Oh, Lord God, I know I'm helping somebody today. I know it's medicine. It's bitter going down, but it's going to be like honey when you get in your belly. So take it. You better not spit it up either. Oh, Lord. That's what mom and dad used to say, right? Come on, get it. Get all of it, right? So get it. Get all of it. It'll help us. I need help. Like I said, if I don't know anybody that needs help. Okay, watch this. He says, I am the Lord. Verse 5, I am the Lord, and there's no one else. There's no God beside me. I will gird and arm you, though you have not known me. He's telling that to a heathen. God said, look, I'm the Lord. Look, I'm strengthening you. You don't even know. You don't even know what's going on, but I'm strengthening you. But now, what to God? Those of us who really know what's going on, can we let God strengthen us? Can we let God gird us? We should be able to let God help us. But the problem is, we don't want to let God help us, because sometimes, oftentimes, God helps us in an area or in a way where we don't want him to help us.
Amen.
Lord, we ain't ready for that. Lord, help me. No. Really? Lord, help me. Yeah? Okay, I'll help you. If you let me help you, I'll help you get rid of that pride. Pride is killing some of us.
Amen.
It's killing some of us. Oh, then in verse number 6, as I move quickly as I can, that man, see, God said, he's tying into purpose. This is why I'm doing this. God has a goal. He has an aim. God does not never do anything just because he wants something to do. He has an end and a purpose in mind. Here's the end and the purpose. He said, that men may know. That men may know from the east and the rising of the sun. And from the west and the setting of the sun, that there is no God beside me. I am the Lord, and no one else is seen. He said, this is why I'm doing this. This is why I'm using these unusual means and methods to show my power and to show my glory and my majesty. Because I want everybody to know, from the east side to the west side, from north and south, everybody on the face of the earth, I want them to know that I am the Lord, that there is no God beside me, that I am the Lord, and no one else, oh Lord, no one else is here. No. So basically what God is saying through this word is that no one else should be Lord of our lives but the Lord. Not even me, oh God. I can't be Lord of my life. I can't even call my own shots. I can't even do what I want to do. I must. It is imperative for me to acknowledge God in all of my ways. I got to seek God for direction. I got to seek God for instruction. But the problem is, my human mind thinks that I know what I need. Sometimes I don't even realize what I need. Sometimes I think I need this or I think I need that. How much money, oh God, have we wasted on something that we thought we needed? We just had to have. And then that thing is in the closet, not the front closet, but the other closet, still got the tags on it. But when we saw it, we needed it, and we had to have it. We don't know what we need. That's why I need thee. Oh, I need thee. Every hour, I need thee. Because if I leave myself to my own human thinking and my own human mind, I'd be more than a mess than I am right now. But thank God for his grace. Thank God for his mercy that he sends. Oh, God, did I say God is talking all the time? Yeah, I think I said that in the beginning, but God is talking, and God sends out messages to us. He said, now, don't do that. Oh, no, don't do that. No, don't go there. No, you should say that. Oh, God says it. Oh, God. Oh, Lord. Okay, I got to say it. God has been working on some of us on one particular thing for some years, Lord, and we ain't let it go yet. God is saying, you might as well let it go, because you're not going to win. It'll be better for you if you just let it go. Bring that thing to me, God, but you're taking my identity. Oh, I read somewhere that our life is hid in Christ with God. So that means my identity has already been taken on Calvary. Jesus Christ, he stretched himself out. He shed his blood for our sins. Wait a minute. I hear the Bible say, if any man be in Christ. Wait a minute. So that's where my identity is. If any man be in Christ, then he is a new creature. Behold, old things. Wait a minute. Old things have passed away. Oh, Lord. The devil hacked in to my identity. He hacked in to your identity in the garden. Ah, with Adam, he hacked in, and the identity of the whole human family was compromised and hacked. He's been perpetrating a fraud for a long time. But the antivirus came, and the antivirus is Jesus, the bomb in Gilead. So God downloaded the antivirus, and we have to go to the website to get it. Where is the website? www.crossofcalvary.com. That's the website. Oh, and everybody has to link up to that website and get to put their faith. Oh, what's the password? Jesus. Oh, wait a minute. There's a firewall on there. What's the password? Water baptism in the name of Jesus. That's the password. Wait a minute. How do you open this file? Oh, I gotta send you something that can open up the file. So, on the day of Pentecost, God downloaded the Holy Ghost. Oh, we can read the document. What format is that? I don't know. That's in another language. Oh, God. But on the day of Pentecost, I'm getting happy now. I'm preaching myself happy. Sit there like that if you want to. But on the day of Pentecost, God downloaded the maximum, updated version of heaven's operating system in the person of the Holy Ghost. Oh, get to the website. Oh, Lord. No, I don't need no tech support. I can do this. Oh, the Holy Ghost is user-friendly. Hallelujah. All you got to do is repent of your sins. God, the God who is, the God who can, the God who will download. Wait a minute, it's already out. God, it's already in the cloud. Hallelujah. Oh, it's already in the cloud. God has already sent the Holy Ghost back. And the Holy Ghost is hovering right now over your seat. And all God wants you to do, oh, you need a USB connection. Wait a minute. God said, you ain't got to have no USB. I'm gonna update you. You get a free upgrade. I'm gonna update you. You can go wireless. Hallelujah. That means you might not even have to plug in to the altar, but if you want a wireless connection, just reach out by faith right where you're sitting. You can get a download of the Holy Ghost. Don't you dare enter 2013 without the Holy Ghost. Get that program. Get that download. Then you got some power. It's free. All free downloads of the Holy Ghost. Oh, Lord. How can I get it? Oh, Staples don't have it. Best Buy don't have it. CD.net don't have it. Office Depot don't have it. But Heaven's Depot already downloaded it. Somebody in here need the Holy Ghost. You've been playing. You've been playing. You've been frightened. You've been pretending. You in your religiosity. Yeah, religiosity, whatever it is. Whatever, all that. You've been playing. But you need the Holy Ghost. You need the real. Oh, God. The real Holy Ghost. The genuine, authentic. Oh, you come to the devil. It's just like a hat. Oh Lord, all right, I'm here now. Lord, help me. The devil, he did you a crack. A crack. Yeah, okay, I'll give you some deep service stuff. Some of y'all know what I'm talking about. If you don't want to go to the store, oh God, and pay no $350 for a program, you can go online. Hear what I said. I'm not telling you to do it, but I'm telling you it's out there. You can go online and download a crack. A crack, that means a counterfeit of the real program. But if you have, let's just say Microsoft, genuine authentic software, that genuine authenticator will say, wait a minute, this ain't the real program. This is a crack, and it will shut it down. Yes. Oh, Lord, where am I going with this? The devil has slipped some of y'all the crack holy ghost. Is he going there? Yes, I am. The devil has sent some of y'all a counterfeit Holy Ghost. The devil has sent it. Wait a minute. If you got the real Holy Ghost, then you should live holy. But may the Lord help me today. Maybe the reason that some of y'all are struggling because you got that crack on a pirated website. The devil sent out one of his demons and slipped you a phony Holy Ghost. So when the authenticator tries to recognize the program, no, it's a bunch of garbage. It's a bunch of jar. It's a bunch of confusion. And I would to God that you come and get the genuine authentic Bible Holy Ghost that they got on the day of Pentecost. You gotta get it like the Bible said. Yes. The Bible said that on the day of Pentecost, they were sitting in one place, and suddenly, the Bible said, suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled the whole house. The whole God filled. I'm trying to circle this whole. God said, walk around the whole house, and it filled the whole house. It filled the whole house. God filled the whole house. Filled the whole house. It filled the whole house where they were sitting. Oh, some of y'all sitting here in this whole house needs to be filled with the precious gift of the Holy Ghost. The Bible said that it filled the whole house. Ah, Lord, anybody out there, in the best of you, come get them. Go get them and get them inside. God, I believe, wants to fill the whole house. Oh, wait a minute, you got to be in the house. Oh, God. Oh, wait a minute. Let me finish this one. I got thoughts come to me so fast, I can't finish them all, but it filled the whole house, the Bible said, when they were sitting, and suddenly there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as of fire. Oh God, let your God is the only thing that can come close to an illustration of God is fire. That's the only element that God made that can really come closer. Because fire, listen, you can't stop fire. No. Fire can burn up water. Yep. Y'all read that in your Bible on Mount Carmel. Fire can burn up rocks and altars and sacrifice. The fire of God can. The Bible said it could.